SlopeCharts handles watch lists better than anything else out there. And what a watch list is a collection, your own collection of symbols, and here's my own, each of which have a meaningful name to me. And you can move things from list to list, or most simply put things into list. Here, for instance, we have the stock applied materials. And so here is the core list, a core list of watch symbols, and I shall click Add and choose where I want it to go. And so AMAT now is in that core list of symbols. And I can move things from place to place naturally. So I could drag this up, for example, to the bullpen. And you can see it's taken out of core and moved into bullpen. And the quantities after those lists are displayed. You can also right click on any symbol to do things to it, move it, copy it, or tag it. In this case, tagging is a way of earmarking a symbol as something special in some way. And you'll see how that's useful in a moment. Here we see you can drag and drop from a list into the chart area. And so that saves you the time of typing in the symbol, or you can just use the up and down arrows on your keyboard to thumb through the lists. Here, if you click on the title at the top, you can create a new watch list, import from a list of symbols. You can search all the symbols from all users for notes. You can subscribe, filter by sector, or show only the tagged symbols. Notice here how the quantities have plunged because it's only showing the tagged symbols. Cryptos, for example, shows just 7 symbols now, but if we go back to just the normal mode, all 99 symbols are there. So as you can see, tagging symbols that are particularly important to you can save you a lot of time with that one click.